I'm going to talk today about the spectral variability of LEDs with angle. Why we have considered this topic to be important. First, we will do the introduction as usually. Then we will explain the experimental setup. Then we will talk about the method that we have followed, the results, and the conclusions. As we all know, the current spectrum and core measurement devices are spectrophotometers or spectrophotometers, and also the multispectral capture systems. Spectrophotometers and spectrophotometers, they measure a spectrum and get XY set, three stimulus. Normally from 400 nanometers up to 700, and in most cases also from 380 to 730. And they can do it in 16 channels at least, and you can also get 64 channels. On the other hand, the multispectral capture systems, they also allow the spectral characterization of a scene, not only points, through several several acquisition channels. These acquisition channels, they have to be more than three channels, and normally they are less than traditional spectrophotometers, so you shouldn't go up to 16 or to 32 channels. And the good advantage is that they have very high spatial resolution using a CCD or a CMOS camera. So then, spectrophotometers and spectrophotometers, they are distinguished to have very good color accuracy and very good spectrum, but they only measure one point. In multispectral systems, you can also get very good color accuracy, and also you add the value of being able to capture a whole image and with a very high spatial resolution. So which are the spectral sampling techniques that we can find? First, we find a technique where you illuminate the image with a white light source. But by white, we mean uniform enough light source with uniform spectrum. And then we use transmission filters with different channels. And we do the spectral reconstruction, and we get the full spectrum of the image for every pixel that the camera can capture. And then we do the color analysis. Another way of doing this is by using different light sources with different spectrums, and then we can illuminate the image and capture the illuminated image, and this will be, in the sense, another way of sampling or filtering the image by different spectrums. So then we can see that we have the two ones. So or we use white light sources, or we can also use color light sources. So let's focus on that now. Traditional light sources are tungsten or also the discharge lamps, like xenon lamps. And lately, the use of LEDs have started to be used a lot. Why? We all know the LEDs are a small size, so that's good. The power consumption is very, very low. That also helps a lot. They have a very high life expectancy, and they are cheap. So these are the main reasons why LEDs usage in the overall lighting industry is very spread. And we consider, okay, let's try to use them for multi-spectral capture systems. So when you start to analyze all the LEDs that you can find in the market, and you go to the manufacturers and you ask what's in the data sheet, there are two informations that they never tell you, and even if you ask them. One is the spectrum change with the angle. Is this important? We don't know. And also, one more that you don't find is the spectrum change with life. I don't have time to show you the spectrum change with life because we will need so many years, and here in Joensuu, it will be a very long time. But I can do a very quick test with you, an example of the spectrum change with the angle. For the good students here in the front, you can see it. The other students, well, I have also this picture. So we see here, from there you can see white. If I start to turn it, you don't see white anymore. Which color are you seeing now? Yellow. So for the people on the back, this is what you see. So we just tested one white LED, and we said, well, maybe this is important. Although manufacturers don't tell, well, if we want to use white LEDs or any color LED for multispectral capture systems that we measure color, if the color of the light source changes with the angle, when we measure images, for sure it's going to be an angle, always. So we need to control it. So let's measure it and let's see what we get. So what do we do to measure it? This is our setup. We use an instrumental system, Spectro 320, spectral radiometer, with an optical probe, this thing here, the UOP-146. And the area, the effective area that we were measuring was 33 millimeters square millimeters. That's approximately 6.5 millimeters of diameter. We position all the LEDs in a motorized rotation system at 15 centimeters from the optical probe. And more or less the viewing angle was 2.5 degrees. So we were capturing 2.5 degrees when we center the optical probe in front of the LEDs. We measure, well, indeed we started to measure from minus 43.2 up to 43.2. But the first measurement showed that we got exactly the same going from minus 43.2 to zero, than going from zero to 43.2. So you will see the data that I will show, the data was from zero to 43.2. And the motor steps were 1.8 degrees. Okay? So we bought LEDs from Nichia, Philips Lumilet, Samsung Technology, the Avago, and Best Hong Kong. So we sample a lot of manufacturers. For the white LEDs, for those of you that know white LEDs, there are different ways of making them. In this case, we just analyzed the white LEDs that are made of a blue LED with yellow phosphors. Why? Because these are the most used. Like 19.999% of the old white LEDs that you can buy, they are made by this method. Also for color LEDs, we also got from all these manufacturers, we got the whole spectrum, from UV to red, going from blue, cyan, green, pink. We also got for every LED different directivity patterns. So when you go to buy LEDs, you will get the same one, and they just change the optic to make it more directivity or less. So more narrow or more broad. But the LED is exactly the same. And you will see what we get there. We also got two specimens of each one of them, and with the same bin. For those of you that know about LEDs, the manufacturers, they differentiate the LEDs when you buy them, and they put them together into bins. Meaning that, in theory, if you buy LEDs from the same bin, the behavior is going to be the same. In our case, we were lucky, and all the specimens that we bought, the two of them were very similar. That's why you will see in our data that we only show one, but if we show two, we will see one, and the other will be under. So in this case, we were lucky. For sure, if you buy LEDs from different bins, the color that you will get is different. Also, we allow always 5 minutes to warm up. Our experiments have indicated with 5 minutes, the color difference, the maximum color difference that you will get will be 0.2 delta E. If you allow 10 minutes, it's 0.1. So also, as you have seen, we have measured a lot of LEDs, so to make the time shorter, we allow 5 minutes because we consider that was good enough to be stable enough. And also, while we take the measurements, the ambient temperature was kept constant. This is also very important because LEDs change behavior and change the color that you see with the ambient temperature. So it's very important to keep the ambient temperature constant to compare. If you don't want to compare, then you don't need to do it. Which were the analyses that we have performed? First, we measure the radians, that's watts per square meter, of corresponding at all the viewing angles that I have mentioned before, from 0 degrees to 43.2, of all the white and all the color LEDs. Once we measure this, we calculate the spectral differences of all the measurements, and we also calculate the chromaticity coordinates, the differences for the white LEDs mainly. And then, for the last 4 years, there are in the market spectrophotometers that uses white LEDs as light sources. So we analyze one of these spectrophotometers to see if what we have found with the light sources also affect to a real spectrophotometer that you can buy. Then, so let's start with the measurements that we have done. First, here are all the white LEDs that we have measured. And let me show you here differences. One, you can see the narrower the directivity, the higher the power that you see. So that's something that we were expecting. One thing that I wasn't expecting is that with the same brand model, if the directivity is broader, I would expect to have the peak in the same position, and it's not. So this also, well, this means like when you buy, the LED is exactly the same, but the optics are changing, and this also affects to the color that you are getting. For those of you that are not used to white LEDs, you will see that although you perceive white, indeed, here there is the blue LED, and they cover the blue LED with phosphors to make perceive white. But as you can see, it's not uniform white. So this can affect to the spectrum quality that you can get, and the signal to noise is going to be different depending on the part of the spectrum that you are analyzing. So we see here the blue LED, the yellow phosphors, we see here a high directivity, so a narrow directivity, and a broad directivity, 120, how the shape is similar, but the power that you get is lower. And also, a very important consideration with white LEDs, we haven't found any white LED yet that covers below 400 nanometers. Okay? So we do the same with color LEDs. So we measure all the color LEDs at the nominal angle. And this is what we get. In the same case than the white LEDs, for the same brand, different directivities, the center point is not the same, so also change. And we see that we cover from 380 nanometers up to 700. Okay? And you can even buy some other LEDs that go lower and go higher. The price changes, but it's very cheap to buy LEDs that cover the whole spectrum without any possible gap. Then let's start measuring all these LEDs that I have shown at different angles. So I'm going to show some examples so you can get my points, and then at the end I will summarize all. Here I use as an example, I don't mention the brand of the LED because we haven't asked permissions for the manufacturers. So I have the data, but I just mentioned that there are different brands. If you want to know the details about which brand was which, I can tell you. But in the paper and also here, I'm not going to say it. So in this case, from brand one, I analyze a white LED of 20 degrees. And I analyze it, what's the spectrum that we get, what's the power per square meter at different angles. We start getting things that we were expecting. If I change the angle, the overall power goes down, okay? And the shapes, they look quite similar. So although the overall power goes down, they look quite similar. Well, what happens if I normalize it? If I normalize it, I see that the blue part of the spectrum shape is kept constant. However, the yellow part of the spectrum is not constant anymore. So the yellow is the effect that we has seen before, but here is a justification. What happens if instead of using a 20 degrees LED, I use an LED with 140? Again, we see here the same shape and how the overall power decreases with the angle. Also, the absolute power, if we compare, it's 5 times lower. So they have brought the directivity because the LED is exactly the same. The point power is lower. So the amount of light that you are getting in one point is lower. In this case, 5 times less. However, the spectrum change with the angle is much lower also. So in the conclusion section, you will see that I'm going to mention this. This is, if I have to choose a white LED for a multispectral system, I would probably prefer to use a white LED with high directivity pattern because the spectrum change with the angle is much lower. I'm going to show you what we got with all the white LEDs. To compare all the white LEDs, one way to analyze it is to divide the maximum value at the blue part of the spectrum by the maximum value at the yellow part of the spectrum. This is a way to compare how much the yellowish effect, that's how we have called it, the yellowish effect of all the white LEDs. And this is what we get. We see that the narrower the directivity of the white LED, the change with angle is more steep. It's more pronounced. So we see here this corresponds to this brand white LED of 15 degrees. And when the directivity pattern gets broader and broader, you see that it's more constant and the change with the angle is much lower. Another way of looking at this is to calculate the chromaticity coordinate and measure the differences. If we average all of them, we see how the difference is increasing with the angle. If we split them into two buckets, in the first bucket, we analyze all the white LEDs with directivity patterns below 70, we see how the color difference is higher than those with directivity patterns over 70. So this is another way of analyzing the same data. So this is what we got with the white LEDs. And the question is, what's going to happen with the color ones? So with the color ones, we analyze them in the same way. I'm not going to show all of them because there were many, as you will see. I show these three as an example. But we got the same for all the color LEDs, except for some that I will show you later. What we got is that the spectrum was exactly the same at any viewing angle. The power, the illumination power, changed, but the spectrum was exactly the same. This is very important for multispectral systems, because if you illuminate an image with color LEDs, you know that the power can change, but you can calibrate that. You can calibrate for the amount of light, but calibrate for the spectrum is much difficult because that's what you are measuring. If you measure something you have to calibrate, things get complex. However, we found two color LEDs that also change with the angle. In this case, this brand one red LED with a directivity pattern of 20, you see that change slightly the spectrum with the angle. And also this one, the amber color, in this case, the change was even higher. From, I don't remember now the number, about 30 color LEDs that we analyzed, there were only two that changed the spectrum with the angle. But this is very important because this means that you have to measure them. We cannot believe that any color LED that you buy are going to be as good as these three. So if we want to use color LEDs also for a multispectral system, we should also measure at least once if they are stable. Then it's up to us to decide if we measure all the color LEDs from the same bin if we have time, or we just believe that if we measure one and it's good, the same brand model with the same bean, the behavior is going to be the same. Then the last analysis that we did, as I told you, we measured a real effect photometer that you can buy in the market that uses a white LED as a light source. If the white LED analysis that we have done before was well done, the measurements taken with this effect photometer should reflect what we have seen before. If we don't compensate for different heights or for different distances or for different angles, if we compensate them, then we wouldn't see any difference. So in this case, we are not going to compensate for measuring at different distances or measuring at different angles. One point that I want to explain to you is how we measure this. So we have a white tile, we have the effect photometer. Imagine that it is the effect photometer, and we take measurements at different distances without changing the angle, and then changing the angle at all these distances. When we only change the distance, what we are seeing is the effect of the white LED at different angles. Why? If we are at the nominal position, we see that in this case, this circle is the measurement area. In this case, we see the effect of the center part of the white LED, the top part, and the bottom part. If the sample is moved, or the effect photometer is moved, imagine that the sample is moved to this position here. Then the effect of the top part of the white LED is higher than the center part. So then the yellowish effect that we have seen before with the angle, we should also see it here. Okay? So we started to take measurements with a lot of samples. In this case, I only show you this example of one spectral photometer with a white tile. And we calculate the delta E 2000 of the nominal position up to 2.5 millimeters away from the nominal position and minus 1.5 millimeters from the nominal position. And also we change the angle plus 1.5 degrees down to 2.5 degrees. And we see a maximum delta E change of 3.5. Okay? And then the question is, well, what's the main influence in this delta E? It would be delta L. I'm not going to show you. Delta L has an effect because you get less tower. But let's concentrate on the hue part or on the color part. So it was very interesting to see that delta A almost doesn't change. So you change all this position, the angle with the effect photometer, and the maximum change in delta A is 0.7 at 2.5 millimeters away from the sample. Then the yellowish effect should be seen in delta B. So let's analyze the delta B. And yes, in the delta B, we see a much higher change than in delta A, up to 2. Okay? So then, after all the results that I have shown, which are the conclusions that you would expect? White light LEDs designed with a blue emitting LED coated with a yellow emitting phosphor emit lights whose spectrum changes with the angle. The higher the directivity, the narrower the directivity, the higher the yellowish effect. Then, if you have enough power with a broad directivity white LED, or with a combination of white LEDs with broad directivities, I would recommend the use of these ones. And try to avoid the white LEDs with very, very high power. You will see in the market that they are increasing the power and that directivity is higher and higher. For multispectral systems, it can be a problem. With single color LEDs, on the other hand, most of them, they don't change the spectrum with the angle. And that's good. However, as I have shown you, sometimes you can get color LEDs that changes slightly the spectrum also with the angle. So we should always check when we get them if the spectrum is constant or not with the angle. And about the effect photometers, as we have seen, those effect photometers that use white LEDs as light sources, they should be calibrated at different distances and different angles if we don't want to get bad color accuracy measurements depending on distances or angles. If you have a system where the distance and the angle doesn't change, like effect photometers that are touching the sample, you are not going to have any problem. But if you have a system where the distance to the sample changes, using a white LED as a light source can provoke bad color accuracy measurements. And also, using only white LEDs, I have shown you, they don't have power below 400 nanometers. So if you want to have an effect photometer from 380 nanometers up to 730, you should use white LEDs in combination with UV color LEDs. With this, I finish my talk. Thank you.
So perhaps we have time just for very quick question.
Please. Do you?
Thank you very much for your talk. I have a question for the white LEDs. It's clear that there is an angle dependence. You have two centers of light emission. Do you have a physical explanation for the red and amber LED, the change with angle?
So my explanation to that is the manufacturing process of these LEDs. The optics also had some coating. And this can explain that the phosphorus used for the coating can also affect to the change. If there is not optic in front of the LED, probably this change wouldn't see. Like if you see, let me show you this one. Let's go fast. You see this one here. This is the pink one. Okay, this pink has two peaks, so it's only one white. It's one LED with two spectrum peaks. So sometimes manufacturers, in order to provoke the spectrum that you wish, it's not a pure LED. So they cover with the optics. They do some strange things in order to get spectrums, visual spectrums. Because when you talk to the manufacturers, most LEDs are not to measure things. The LEDs are to illuminate the places. And they sell millions of LEDs for things like this, for rooms. So the quality of the LEDs are very low for in color basis, if we think. So if you want to buy really good LEDs, very stable ones for color measurements, they look at you and say, are you sure? So that's a problem that we can face in the future when we try to use LEDs for multispectral systems, that it could happen that the quality of the LEDs, instead of going up, goes down, because they sell millions and millions into different markets, and they don't get focused on high quality ones.
Okay, thank you.